benchmarks are being run, and this tool is just a way to present the numbers. Unfortunately, it looks like none of the last 50 commits to THE changed any of the performance numbers in any significant way. So let's try to load the other hundreds of commits, and then it looks like this. And you see it has some colors, and you can see whether it has improved or not. You can look at the report for an individual commit. That is slow. Great. And you have nice graphs. Yeah, this is an old commit, so it's off the graph, otherwise you would see the change here. Maybe let's show you something different. So I want to show you both the tool for the THE hacker. So if you're a THE hacker, you can check it for performance things, at least after you committed it. But also the software is generic, so if you use it for your own projects, you can. For example, I use it for this. So basically, anytime you have numbers per Git commit in any way, you can just get the data into this, and this is the amount of ink in my work in process PhD thesis measured in, measured in pages. So if I compress my thesis, it'll be almost 8 pages by now. it's only the dashboard, so it doesn't help you collect the data. You may still need your Jenkins or Bash script or whatever to run the benchmark for every commit, and then you just put all the out the log files, get out of it into this is still back to GFC. And then you dump all the log files into a directory and add some settings, and it produces static files that have all this nice view. And a side effect, I also have a Git repository with lots of THE build logs if you ever need them. But don't try to check it out directly. It'll be 16 gigabytes of file. So keep it as a bare Git repository and use Git plumbing to exit. Looks like, oh, it's, yeah. I guess that's what I wanted to say.
Shake,
but also like Shake because everybody's using Shake these days.
Does that mean it actually
has binary, and it has the tool itself. So it would be cool to have much more.